say that the king will have the ball in his hands when it matters most. Take a listen.
When you get to the end of the game, that's what, you know, max players make max money for. That's what they do. So, I can comfortably say LeBron will be our first option at the end of ball games if it's close.
Good day when we've got Rob Parker here.
What's happening?
Welcome.
That's debatable. But...
There's no debate, Skip.
How are you,
Rob? Keep you guys honest.
Good
but
morning.
Skip.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you make of those comments?
I was shocked this even came up. So let me get this straight. LeBron James, you say the greatest player on the planet, right?
Yep.
So he joins a team with a bunch of kids and a bunch of spare parts. And this is an issue of who's going to take the last shot? Let's do the maximum reach here. What if Michael Jordan in his prime had joined this Laker team? Would it even come up about who's going to take the last shot?
There would be no question.
It would be laughable, right? It would be so laughable that it would not be the question. And he answered the question with a straight face like, oh, yeah. Well, actually, it's going to be LeBron. What? The point is that throughout his career, and Luke certainly knows this subliminally, there's been a nagging doubt about LeBron in the clutch because for years and years, it looked like he would run from the last second shot, especially if the game wasn't tied. If his team was down 1, 2, or 3 points, he would run from the last second shot or run from the potential free throw line by taking the ball to the basket. And as we know, he did not hit a walk-off shot until his sixth year in the league at Golden State against Ronnie Turioff, a game I was watching on a Friday night from New York City. And then he hit the other shot heard around the world against Orlando in game two at Cleveland in those playoffs. Again, that's back in 2009, sixth year. And then he didn't hit his next one until his 12th year against Chicago when he got angry at David Blatt for calling Kyrie's number at the end of the game against the Bulls in Chicago. It was a big game, big shot, but he got mad. And I love LeBron when he gets mad because he said, give me the ball and get out of my way. And he made it from the corner. And then last year, he showed some real growth in his 15th year because he hit three. And that was stunning, but still nagging doubt sort of hangs over LeBron's career. Clutch or not clutch? Clutch. Matter of factly, last second shot, it's LeBron. Oh, really? Not Kyle Kuzma? I don't know. I think Kyle Kuzma can make last second shot.
First of all, Skip, all he did was state the obvious. Everybody know LeBron James. First of all,
why wouldn't he laugh at
LeBron James has more game-winning playoff shots than who, Skip?
I don't know.
You know Michael Jordan. He has more game-winning shots than Michael Jordan.
Who has more championships?
All I remember is Michael Jordan holding the pose at Utah because I was there in the front row. Holding the pose.
That's what LeBron did. You remember he was skating out of bounds? He hit that thing off Toronto?
You mean the one he didn't intend to bang?
Yeah, he meant he meant to bang it. Skip, you see, every time, this is what you and Rob Parker do. Y'all try to diminish LeBron. Is that, he hit a walk-off shot, but the score was tied. If you don't mind me asking, just give me the floor here. When Kyrie hit that to put him up three, what was the score in that game? Was it down? So if he'd have missed that shot, would they have lost the game?
Game seven?
Yeah.
At Oakland?
Yes.
That's a much bigger shot, Shannon.
I'm just asking a question.
The score was tied. Okay. We got it. Okay.
So if the score is tied, it doesn't make a difference.
You don't think that's a clutch shot on the road in a game seven winner takes all? I'm asking you.
You didn't say that when he hit that game. LeBron hit the game when against Toronto.
They were going to overtime.
They were going to overtime in the game. Golden
State. They weren't. It wasn't automatic that they were going to overtime.
Well, how do you know then?
No, but it wasn't.
How do you know?
All I'm saying, when LeBron hit those two shots, it's a lot easier to make that shot, Shannon. You know that.
Skip.
Compared to being down. I was in Cleveland, Skip, when Michael Jordan made that shot to win the series. That was for the series, Shannon. Don't tell me that's the same shot as it's
okay,
the
what about the one
shot.
In Chicago when they were down? The one in Chicago when they were already down.
Was it the second round?
Yeah. Hold on. That was the first round in which he beat Cleveland. That wasn't the Eastern Conference Finals.
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
It was a five-game series on the road against a good Cleveland team.
Oh, now they're good.
They were good.
Which one are we talking about?
Well,
when Jordan hit that game.
On
against,
Elo?
Yes.
That was early. That was
first round.
Right? First round. That was like candy from a baby.
That was the first round.
It was a great shot.
Oh, so you see what you did?
No, I didn't.
It was a great shot.
It was. It was for the series. series, Shannon, though. Shannon, stop.
I know this. I saw an 18-year-old freshman named Michael Jeffrey Jordan that I wasn't even that aware of.
Yeah.
I saw him on the floor surrounded by greatness in the
big
NCAA.
Fam Bam.
He made it.
Yeah. Hold on.
And he made the clutch jumper to win the game.
Hold on. Where'd you see him?
1982. I was there in the front row.
How
18?
Oh, I saw an 18-year-old guy that opened up in Sacramento that went for 25-5-5. An 18-year-old.
Did they win the game?
Didn't he win? Wait, didn't he hit a walk-off till he was 6 years in the league?
Wow. Hold on. So 6 years in the league, that would have made him 24.
Hmm.
So by the time Michael hit his first one, what? Michael was what? 24, that was his third year in the league.
Hmm.
LeBron had been in the league 6 years by then.
I look at Luke Walton, too, here a little bit. Skip, I'm with you. You shouldn't even have to say that. I would have laughed at a reporter would have asked me this question.
Seriously?
I would have said, seriously, really? Like,
oh, but to
me, I got this, like, he put LeBron on blast. You're getting paid.
Yeah.
So we expect you not to pass the ball to Lonzo Ball or pass the ball to somebody else looking for them to bail you out. You're getting the money. You just got a big deal. You came to L.A.
I agree.
He put LeBron on blast.
Well,
we expect you to be that guy, not to pass the buck, Shannon Sharpe.
I'll get to you in a minute. So, Skip Bayless, you wanted Luke Walton to laugh that off because it should be beyond ridiculous.
Well, what are your options?
Let me finish. What? You wanted to laugh that off because of
You want Lance to take it?
Beyond ridiculous. But you want LeBron to sit there and say, okay, LeBron, what are you going to do to get the fans' loyalty? You don't want him to laugh that off. And Rob Parker, you need to stop.
Wait a minute. LeBron's
history is that
he walks out on everybody.
He has
a loyalty problem with fans. What are you talking about? He walked out on his own hometown twice, Shannon.
Hold up.
That's a real question.
Why are you here?
Did he walk out
on
Miami?
You walked out on Detroit. Why are you here?
I didn't walk out on Detroit.
You were the first black columnist in the Detroit Free Press history in 150 years. Why are you here today?
I like the sunshine.
Oh, yeah, you walked out on your team. So LeBron James, he can't transfer. Jenny, is this the only job you've ever had? Jenny has a problem with loyalty. Skip Bayless. Oh, he worked at the Miami. He worked at the L.A. Times, Chicago, Dallas, Morning Luke.
Don't forget San Jose Mercury.
Oh, really? Skip Bayless. So, Skip Bayless.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do that, Skip. Rob Parker, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. LeBron James has more game-winning shots than Michael Jordan, more game-winning shots than Kobe Bryant, but somehow we get this notion he's not clutch.
Mm-hmm. For the record, career-wise, late and clutch free throw shooting, LeBron's a 57% free throw shooter. You don't want to see him at the free throw line.
That's why he passes up the ball at the end.
Okay.
I mean, Skip, we can go to these second-level stats, but we said clutch. He hitting the shot. And it's just like the notion LeBron isn't a scorer. We look at Kevin Durant as being a scorer. But who has the high scoring average between the two? You know the answer. You just don't want to say it.
What?
What?
Shannon Sharp, to close our case
on
the side of the table, what happened at the end of game one of the finals last year in Oakland when LeBron had played one of the greatest games he's ever played?
Yes.
And made 7 of 14
shots. He was unbelievable, Skip. He was unbelievable that night.
He was on fire from range.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, with 7 seconds left, he gets the switch he needs with little Steph on him, guarding him.
Take him to the hole.
Or just pull up. Pull up and shoot it because he can't follow your shot.
There was KD over there.
That's fine.
Pull
up and take the shot, but you're down a point, and if you miss it, the game is going to be over. So what does he do at the last second? He says, I'm going to pass the buck.
To another NBA player.
I'm going to pass it to George Hill, who's playing in his first finals while I'm playing in my ninth finals. Really? What are you doing? You're LeBron James.
At some point, everybody had his first NBA finals. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to pass the ball to another NBA player and see if he can make a layup.
NBA player.
Yeah.
San Antonio said, you're out.
But in all the years, you never see LeBron catch and shoot.
Well,
stop it, Skip Bayless.
Luke Walton says, I think it's LeBron.
I think
LeBron will take our last shot because he better take it.
Rob, thank you.
Oh,
world historian.
That was wild.
Rob, you ought to be shaved.
Always.
You ought to be shaved yourself.
Come on, man. Wait a minute.
Whatever.
Well, the Rams stay undefeated tonight against the Vikings. I don't even want to say that out loud because I just... It's not going to happen. We'll discuss next.